Hello, this is Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri. Today I'll be discussing a very interesting topic, that is Saade Saathi, or 7.5 years of the most feared cycle of Saturn. Actually, most of the people get very scared by the term itself, 7.5 years or Saade Saathi period. Saade Saath means exactly 7.5 years. I'll tell you why it is called so. Now, actually, Saturn is a slow-moving planet. And whenever he enters into any zodiac sign, he stays there for 2.5 years. So if he stays in 3 zodiac signs, that will be 2.5 plus 2.5 is 5 plus 2.5 is 7.5 years Saturn. Now, how is this calculated? This is calculated as per your moon sign or Chandra Rashi. Now, what is Chandra Rashi? When we consider the moon sign as the important one and we write it in the first position, that becomes your moon sign. So, or Rashi Kundali, that is called as. Now, if you consider that Saturn, when he enters your 12th sign from moon Rashi. Now, what do I mean by 12th sign from moon Rashi? Suppose you are a Leo or Sinha Rashi. Okay, so your moon is placed in Leo. Okay, so what is the previous sign to that? That becomes your Cancer or Karka. So when Saturn enters this Karka, your Saade Saathi begins. So he will stay there for 2.5 years. Then he will come on your moon sign. He will stay there for 2.5 years, so 5 years. Then after that, he goes to the next one. That is, if I am considering Leo, he came first to Karka or Cancer. Then he came to Leo. And then he will go to Virgo or Kanya Rashi. So after he moves to Tula, your Saade Saathi 7.5 years period is over. Now, Vedic astrology actually considers 3 kinds of horoscopes. One is the Lagna Kundali or ascendant chart, then moon sign or moon chart, and the other one is sun sign or sun chart. Usually solar chart or sun sign chart, that is Surya Rashi, is considered for routine events or when event takes place. If we want to decide exactly when is the time of marriage going to be. So we see the moment of moon also, of course, and sun along with other planets. Anyway, for Saade Saathi, we are considering moon sign. Now, actually what happens is, why people fear like this? See, Saturn is not somebody to be feared. We actually personify all the planets, like we call him Shani Deva or Lord Shani. So you don't have to fear, but Shani is like that tough teacher who doesn't spare anybody. Okay, see, like, you know, whether you are a very rich man, whether you're a poor man, whether you are able, you're unable, whatever kind of a category you belong to, he just confers either blessings or sufferings according to your karma. So whatever your past deeds and present deeds together, when they fructify, Shani is there to teach you the lesson and, you know, make you learn valuable lessons in life. Not teaching lessons means it's not just like that. You will experience and you will start learning. So that is Saade Saathi. But if you are truthful and if you really, really work hard and, you know, please Shani, Lord Shani, it is not by offering lots of money or, you know, offering lots of stuff to Shani temple. It's not like that. You have to improve your behavior, you have to reflect on your behavior, and you have to improve upon whatever the things are. I'll be talking to it as I proceed further. Anyway, whatever I am saying is completely a generic kind of a thing. What is this Saade Saathi? And don't fear. It all depends, like, see, whether it's going to be a mild difficulty or severe difficulty or no difficulty, this depends on all other placements of all other planets, and also most importantly, how sanity the Saturn is placed in your horoscope. Is he malefic? Is he benefic? Is he in enemy camp? Is he in friendly camp? And also, like, is he a Karaka Graha for you, or is he going to confer blessings on you? This again, the Janmakshara or this chart is made as per the sky, whatever. The day when you were born, whatever the arrangement was in the sky, it depends on that. So it all, how do you get that chart also? You get as per your previous karma, whatever deeds you have done. That is why we say all the material wealth remains in this world, including our own body. We leave it here only and go. Only thing that comes with us is the knowledge and our karma. So that is how the planet replacements and all that. And this, our wise sages and those who wrote astrology and all these things, they have told thousands of years back. They had that much of mental vision, or they could connect and learn something. Their learning was not through Google, only it was through mental capacity. All right. Now, having said this, let us proceed to understand what is the meaning of exactly Sansa. It has got three phases, as I said, because it enters three zodiac signs. So when Saturn enters the 12th sign from your moon sign, as I just gave in the example, I'm taking that example, for a Sinha Rashi or Leo moon sign, it is when he enters in Karka or Cancer. When he enters there, this 2.5 years is going to be a kind of tough in the sense, understand this logic. It's a very logical science. Astrology is a very logical science. That's why I get fascinated. 12th house is called as Vyasthana. What is Vaya? Vaya means expenditure. Expenditure does not mean only your money. The minute we say profit or expenditure or income, we think only in terms of money. No. Expenditure of your mental health, your mind, your feelings, your emotions, and of course, material, and even your physical expenditure. That means when your energies are lost, that also is an expenditure. Or when you lose your relations, that also is a kind of expenditure. You lost something in life. So these are all the things that you need to understand. So what happens is, of course, there will be financial loss, and there may be difficulty in getting the same income or regular income. Or if you are in a business, paisa bhi ruk ruk ke aayega, it doesn't come in one stretch. So all these are possible. And also, futile disputes with family members and, or colleagues, then harassment will begin at, it may be at home or workplace, depending on the situation. See, to get a harassment at workplace or home, there is no gender bias, like whether you have to be a female or male. Anybody can get harassed in whatever situation. So what happens is, this disturbs the harmony of the individual, and naturally you are not at peace. Constantly thinking about, what's going wrong or what is happening, or, there is a constant kind of, kind of trouble you experience. All right. So then even there are problems in your journey, and there'll be a kind of secret enemies. And especially at workplace, I'll tell you, I always tell this statement. I always told this to my colleagues and juniors, everybody, because in the workplace, nobody is your friend, nobody is your foe. It is like there is no permanent friendship, there is no permanent enmity. People use you as per their convenience. As long as you are convenient to them, you are their friend. As long as once the work is over, they don't have anything left to take from you, then you become their enemy. So that's a very weird kind of human mentality. Anyway, so there'll be secret enemies and mental stress and delays in the workplace, or projects is also not very uncommon. So this is the rising phase. Now, in this rising phase, if at all so many difficulties and hurdles we are going to face, what are we supposed to do? One should learn to cope up with delays and patience. That is what Saturn wants us to do. So hard work and go on the right path, though there are certain shortcuts. Don't yield to any temptations or shortcuts to achieve something. So, and also resolve your problems peacefully and try not to talk much during this period. And also avoid taking risks in heavy investment. You should not invest heavily at all during this period. Even if you are into a share market or a business and all that, you need to be extremely careful on how much money you are investing. So that you need to take care. Now, the second one is called as optimum phase. In optimum phase, what happens? Saturn comes on your moon sign. Now, who is moon in astrology? Moon is your mind. So it is called Chandrama Manaso Jataha. So what do we mean by this? When Saturn comes there, again, a kind of Saturn doesn't actually fog your thinking or something. He makes you gloomy. He makes you feel worthless. So like, you know, you start feeling completely, you know, something is lacking in me. That kind of a feeling comes. And also definitely to some extent, again, depending on your horoscope, natal horoscope, health problems are not very uncommon. So when any health problems come during this phase, you need to be extremely careful not to ignore anything, you know. So don't take it easy. It might lead to something else later. So you need to actually take care of your health in a very good way. So nothing will happen. Right? So what happens is when you start feeling depressed or gloomy or, you know, you slow down, then you feel that everybody else is conspiring against you. So that is a very, this thing. And people also will start doubting you. Once your performance is a little bit here and there because you don't control your mind, so what happens is people will start gossiping about you, however good you a worker you are, or they might start pitching against you. The person whom you are trusting and telling everything may go and backstab you, and you know, just to become good in boss's eyes, he can go and tell anything against you, which may not be truth. He will have his karma, it will come back to him. There's no escape from that. But you are going to suffer. That's another thing. So you need to control your tongue. You need to not trust anybody in this period. And also, you know, this is a very typical period. Like even when you work so hard, you don't get success. This is again another trait of optimum phase, that is when he comes from your moon sign. And naturally, then you become gloomy, you become aloof, and you know, then there is depressed, and then there is loss of clarity in your thinking. And even decision making suffers. So this is this phase also, you should avoid doing any very, very important projects or things and all that. So take your time, or you know, if you have to go ahead, if you're in active business or active job and all that, but think thoroughly and then get it. Now, what advice I would like to give in this case? Naturally, actually, first 2.5 years you have suffered. Next 2.5 years are also not going to be easy. As per my experience, what I have seen, automatically people become spiritually inclined. Whatever religion, whatever, whether they believe in astrology, they don't believe in astrology, whatever religion they belong to, they start praying, they start going to the temples and churches and mosques as per their this thing. And trust me, prayers really work. Prayer is nothing. See, whatever prayer you want to take, you will take. But it is your connection with the higher self of God. So you are going to pray, you are going to talk to him and talk about your difficulties. Instead of pouring your difficulties in front of other person who may not be even interested in listening to you, it is better to communicate with God and tell about your difficulties and seek ways to come out of it. There's a beautiful saying, you know, like also like, see, it's not actually a saying. I mean, they say that, you know, when you talk about your problems to people, 70% of them are very happy that you've got problems. And remaining 30%, they don't bother, they don't care. Then why speak about the problems? So that is the thing. So you better get connected to the higher self and, you know, or God, and then you talk about yourself. So any minor health or symptoms, I already told, you should not ignore. Immediately seek medical help. And another thing is, one must follow ethical and honest practices and truthful ways. That is what Saturn ultimately wants us, like, you know. And don't get into any kind of underhand dealings or cheating in business or, you know, doing cheating in the job or even relationships. This will lead to disaster later. It may not immediately happen, but it will definitely lead to disaster. Now, the third phase is when he moves out of your moon sign and goes to the next sign. In this case, from Leo, that is Sinha Rashi, to Kanya Rashi or Virgo. So when he goes there, this is called as setting phase or concluding phase. Again, what is the period? 2.5 years. So in these 2.5 years, things will start easing, but I wouldn't say that everything is going to, you know, come immediately bed of roses. Some people say, no, everything will get back and all that. Again, it depends on your karma, what you have done during the Sadisati or even in your previous karmas, whatever, depending on that, you will get the result. So, initially, some financial difficulties may be there, but definitely things will start easing out for you because he is in the process of moving ahead. But again, delays are common. but it's not going to be a very harsh period at that time. But again, avoid taking risk during this period also. So if you are, to tell you very honestly, as a conclusion, Shani is a Shasana Karak. He's a very disciplined planet. He teaches you lesson, tough teacher. And he doesn't differentiate and discriminate. Aap Raja ho ya rang, farak nahi padta. You know, you are a king or you are just a pauper. He doesn't care. For him, everybody is equal in his eyes. So what you should do is, like, you need to be honest throughout life, of course, but at least in Sade Sati, make sure ki you don't hurt others unnecessarily, don't plot against anybody, don't get into any kind of bribe or underhand dealings, you know. Follow a righteous path, that is one thing. And secondly, Shani gets pleased if you treat your subordinates or your class 4 employees very, very sympathetically. Because Shani ka, when we have certain, in astrology, it's very, different. Like, Sun is called the king, Moon is called the queen, and, Mercury is called, planet Mercury, he is called the Yuvraj or, prince. Likewise, Shani is servant. So, he always identifies himself with the masses. Who are the masses? Masses are not a large gathering. What is the largest population? That is the very, poor people or, small-time workers, all these people. That is, identity of Shani. So, be kind to them. And also, on Saturdays, go to Shani temple and offer whatever you can. Daan when we give, what you give, how much you give, it is not counted by money or anything. It is your intention. How truthfully or really genuinely wanting to give, that you can do. And visit Hanuman temple or Shani temple on Saturdays. And try to avoid alcohol and non-vegetarian. Actually, Shani is very fond of non-vegetarian and alcohol. That is a trait of Shani because he is Anteja. Anteja means low caste. But he will not spare if you do that. So try to keep away from these things and be truthful. And every Saturday, make it a point to offer, some fried thing. It could be a plate of bhajiyas or two samosas or, a packet of chuda, whatever you feel, to poor people, especially if you could find a crippled or, a crippled person or a handicapped person, Shani will be very much pleased. But again, if I don't get time, so I will go once in a month and I will give 20 packets, 30 packets. No. Shani is again a very structured and a disciplined planet. If you appear, if you want to please him, you have to be regular in whatever you do. So every Saturday you do this and you will see the difference and you will not even come to know how you tide through this period. So you will have to go and offer. So especially offering food and fried food is very good for, good remedy for this. And also chanting, Om Namah Shivaya continuously whenever your mind is free would really, really help. Because Lord Shiva is the one who created all the 9 planets. So Shani has to obey and, listen to him. And also Hanumanji. So pray to Lord Hanuman, go to his temple. So you can chant any Hanuman mantra you are comfortable with. But Chadakshari or Panchakshari, Om Namah Shivaya or Namah Shivaya. Whatever you are used to. So chanting these mantras definitely helps you. Again, as I told, there is no need for you to fear about Sade Sati or 7.5 year cycle of Shani. Do your karmas very, be aware of what you are doing. We all do our karmas, but you be aware of what you are doing and be genuine. And definitely he will bless you. Shani Deva will bless you. So don't get worried. These are all generic things I have told. It's not necessary that you will go through all this stuff. As I again told, I again reiterate the same thing. It depends on your planetary combinations and where Saturn is placed and which dasha you are going through, what period you are going through. So it all depends on that. So all the best. Good luck. Shubham Bhavat.